So we'll look at the evolution of the routing table at the source using the SCORL's approach to key-based routing, where in every step, we are going half the distance towards the desired destination. Now, reducing the distance by exactly half may not always be possible because I may not have a way to reach that particular node. So it is approximately we're reducing the distance by half. So let's run through this example to illustrate how this key-based routing works. So the XOR distance between the source and the destination is 10. So the target for my first hop is going to be to a node that is 5 distant from the desired destination. The node that is 5 distant from the desired destination is node number 1, because the XOR of 1 and 4 is 5. So this is my target, that is half the distance to my desired destination. But unfortunately, I don't have a direct way of reaching 1 because I don't have that entry in my routing table. And therefore, I'm going to go to a node that is approximately half the distance. And I could have gone to either 2 or 0, close to the desired half the distance metric. But to make forward progress towards the desired destination, I'll go to this guy who is 4 distant from the desired destination. So I make an RPC call to this node because I cannot reach him. I go to him and I'm going to ask him, hey, I am looking for someone who is too distant from my desired destination, which is 4. And when I send this request over to him, he responds to me and says, look, I have information on 3 nodes that are not exactly too distant, but close enough. 4, 5, and 7 are the nodes that I have who are close enough to the too distant neighbor that you're looking for. The too distant neighbor is this guy. But even this node that I'm reaching that is 4 distant from my desired destination, he doesn't know anyone that is too distant from the destination. And so he's going to respond to me and say, I don't have exactly what you're looking for, but I have information about nodes 4, 5, and 7 that are close enough to who you're looking for. That's the information that I get back. So when I get the response from this node, what I'm getting back is information on how to reach nodes number 4, 5, and 7. So I'm now going to populate my routing table to evolve it to this new state, where it shows that in addition to what I started with originally, I have now new information about how to reach node number 4, node number 5, which I already had, and node number 7, which is the new information I got. So you can see that from this, I evolved to this by adding 2 more reachable entries in my routing table, namely the nodes 4 and 7. So what do I want to do next? Well, the next thing that I want to do is I want to go to someone who's too distant from the desired destination, because I reduce the distance by half, and now I want to reduce it even further by half. That means I want to get to a node that is too distant from the desired destination. That is this guy right here. But I don't have a way of reaching him. So I'm going to go to a node that is close enough to the desired target. The target is too distant from the desired destination. I don't have an entry for him. I could either go to the guy that is 3 distant from the desired destination, or that is 1 distant from the desired destination. Obviously, I want to go closer to the destination. So I'm going to go to this guy. Normally, if I went to the guy who is too distant from the destination, I would have asked him for, I'm looking for someone who is 1 distant from the desired destination. But in this case, it turns out that I've already reached the guy that is 1 distant, because I did not have an entry for the guy who is too distant from the desired destination. So this guy is going to get my request that says, I'm looking for somebody who is 1 distant from the desired destination. And he looks at his routing table and says, these are the nodes that I know satisfy the criteria that you're looking for, 4, 5, and 7. That's what I get back. You notice one thing that is happening here, and that is after my first hop, I got back node IDs 4, 5, and 7 which are the response for my request saying, I'm looking for somebody who's too distant from the desired destination, because he gave approximately the nodes that are having that characteristic of being too distant from the desired destination, including the node number 4 itself. So my table evolved at this step with a direct way of reaching node number 4 as well. But notice that I'm not being greedy here, because in the second step, I want to reduce my distance only by half from the first step, and that is I want to go to somebody who's too distant from the desired destination. That's what I did, and I got back this response, and when I get back that response, I'm going to populate my table again. But it turns out I did not get any new information at this step, because I already have the information about 4, 5, and 7 at the end of my first RPC call as well. Now I have a way of reaching the desired destination, and in my conscience I can feel good that I've not been greedy. I can now, the target is 0, and now I can make that call directly to the desired destination and get back the response that I want. So you can see that in this Corals key-based routing, using this idea of reducing my distance to my desired destination by half at every hop, what it results in is the fact that the latency that I'm going to experience in order to reach my desired destination is increased, because I have to take more number of hops in order to get to the desired destination. Even if I have a direct way of reaching my desired destination, I am not doing that. I'm actually reducing my distance by half every time in order to get to my desired destination. And the reason is I'm placing common good more important than my own latency. I'm avoiding the tree saturation that can occur at the destination if everybody is greedy. That comes at the cost of increased latency, but that's okay. What we are shooting for is common good.